Good morning. It's a brand new month with a bunch of fun, brand new songs. All right. I'm going to start off with a Jenna Stanfield song. Jenna, oh, but how about if I do this? I'm going to just let these guys groove, get the groove on. Stand as you are willing.
Dance, girl.
Dance.
Are we ready?
Hey, na, 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 more than enough. Hey, na, 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 more than enough. Hey, na, 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 more than enough. Hey, na, 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 more than enough. I have more than of all that I need to do all I can do, be all I can be as I go through this day. This is my creed, I have more than enough of all that I need. I have more than enough of all that I need. Hey, na, 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 more than enough. Take a quick look back at dreams of yesterday. Dreams of living the life that you live today. Compared to where we were, we've come all this far. Why not spend the day enjoying where we are? I have more than enough of all that I need to do all I can do. Be all I can be as I go through this day. This is my creed, I have more than enough of all that I need. I have more than enough of all that I need. Hey, na, 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 more than enough. Hey, na, 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 more than enough. Hey, na, 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 more than enough.
Awesome.
Thank you for the beautiful music and our wonderful dancer. And thank you for joining us on this beautiful Sunday morning. Welcome, everyone, to Shining Mountain Center for Spiritual Living, where we're gathering together today to honor the God in ourselves, each other, and to be grateful for all of our blessings. Please join me in reciting our statement of purpose. Our community lovingly and joyfully inspires and empowers individuals to discover and express their divinity. This is a community that recognizes the power of prayer. And we love to pray because we know it's a tremendous power in the universe and we can use it. So, if something's on your mind or in your heart, you got two options. You can join us immediately after the service for a prayer circle, or you can fill out a prayer card in the back. Put it in the prayer chest, put your name on it or not, it's up to you. We have some announcements today. We have meditation every Wednesday at 7:30. It's led by Reverend Linda on Zoom. Sorry about that. But she can be Reverend Zoom sometimes. It's on Zoom. And there are cards on the back table to tell you how to access that meeting. This is a really nice midweek pickup. It helps rebalance your energy as the crazy days continue. Tomorrow, on October 2nd, we'll be feeding the Flathead at Bethlehem Lutheran Church. We need volunteers to show up at the Bethlehem Lutheran Church about 5:30, and there's a sign-up sheet in the foyer. Reverend Linda is going to be leading a foundations class starting October 5th. The sign-up sheet's on the back table. I would highly recommend everybody take this class. Whether you've had it before or not had it before, it's a really good way to understand the spiritual connection and principles of this Center for Spiritual Living. And the thing I love the most about it is it teaches us how to pray and be comfortable with that. Bill Kale with the Healing Tibetan Singing Bowls is going to be back on October the 16th from 6:30 to 8:30 with his bowls. This is a transcendent experience. One thing about these Tibetan bowls, they'll take you to places you haven't been to before. Miracles can happen sometimes. Chairs are available, as you see, but if you want to lie down to experience this, bring a mat or a blanket. So now, we're going to do something a little bit different with Greet Your Neighbor. I want you to turn to your neighbor, the person next to you, and tell them, I'm grateful for the good in your life. I'm grateful for the good in your life. Well, if you would like, you can remain standing or not, but please join our wonderful musicians in our congregational song, We Are One in the Spirit.
Hand in hand, and together
spread the news that God is in our land. And we'll know and believe it by our love, yes, they'll know and believe it by our love.
Tag that.
Yes, they'll know and believe it by our love.
Come to that time in our service where we get to bless our children and bless the child within each one of us, knowing that knowing that truly we are all the children of the divine. And so I'd like to ask you now to please join me in this prayer for our children. We see you who you really are, made in the image and likeness of God. We cherish you, we support you, and we love you. And so from this space of love, let us move within, knowing truly there is only one power, one presence, one life in the universe. It is in this essence of the divine that we live and breathe and have our being. We know there is absolutely nothing, nothing outside of God. And we are one with it. One with light and love and peace and joy. One with prosperity and wholeness. One with the one. Individualized expressions of God. Individualized expressions of love. And so as I speak my word this day for today's service and for the ensuing week, I know that we were cradled in the arms of Spirit, that we move through our days with ease and grace, that we embrace the opportunities to be more that are given to us. I affirm our health and our wholeness, and I'm grateful. I'm grateful for the powerful presence of Spirit within each one of us here today. I am grateful for the light and the love and the laughter that we share. I am grateful for the opportunity that we have to come together. And I am grateful that we are here today. I simply say thank you, God, now as I release this word to the perfect working of the perfect law, which always, always and only says yes. Please join me in affirming. And so it is.
She's my sister. and love for one another. It's a long, long road from which there is no return while we're on the way to there. Why not share?
Okay, I think they need a standing ovation for that. Yeah, come on, you guys. Come on. All of them. Yeah. Woo. Wow. Wow, that was beautiful. Whoa, good morning. God danced the day we came together. Oh, gosh, that was such beautiful music and all of this. What is going on with the lights? The lights are out here. Would you, someone, turn them on, please, for me? Linda, would you? Yeah, there's two. And if I can't see what I'm thinking, it becomes a problem, you know? Thank you, that's perfect. Ask and you shall receive, and then there was light. Thank you, darling, thank you. Okay. You turned the fan on. Yeah, you turned the fan on, honey. There we go. Oh, my goodness. So now that we're together here and we've experienced the fabulous music from the time they opened this service, wasn't it fabulous? Oh, my gosh. And it all fits with what we're going to be experiencing this month. I'll be talking about it, but we'll all be experiencing it, because what the theme for this month is for us is together we thrive. Together we thrive. Oh, and all of the music brought us to that point, you know, of recognizing we're sisters and brothers. We do this together. Oh, my gosh, every bit of it. And that's the entire intention of coming into community. In community, we thrive. And we come into community together. What happens when we come into community? Many things happen. First, we're seen, usually. And if we're seen, we're often heard in community. So we're recognized, right, as a part of something. So we get to belong. And what makes a thriving community? Because that's what we are. I want to talk about what a thriving community looks like. And thriving to me is about success. It's about living in a better way. It's about bringing forth more than we would have individually or singly without community. It means a richness in life. And I think that to thrive is a natural desire within all of us to thrive. I think we all want to thrive. I think we all want to have a goodness in life, joy in life, peace in life, harmony in life. Challenges, too, because we grow from them, you know? We learn through our challenges most of the time. Yeah, so it's all good. It's all good if we can put it into perspective. So to thrive also means to prosper. We want to prosper in our lives, and that's also about being successful. my glass is too tall. And to prosper in health, we want to have better health, don't we? We want to have better relationships if we have a strained relationship, even one in our life. And even if it's old, wouldn't it be lovely to bless it and lift it and let it be? Bless it and lift it and just let it be. Because when we do that, we bring our energy and our power back to the energy that is within us so that we can have that feeling of thriving and be participants in the community that we choose to be in community with, and therefore contribute more of that authentic, magnificent self that you are, that we all are, to that community and to life and to the world. Because we all have a gift. We all have a gift of life. And out of that gift of life that we're all sitting here, standing here, laying down, whatever y'all are doing at this moment, we all have the gift of life to draw from. We all have that gift of life to draw from, that power of life that is within us, that once we claim it and once we name it, which what is it? It's the life, it's God. The life within us is God. The life outside of us is God. The life around us is God. Spirit, Wonkin Tonkin, whatever you want to call it, as long as you recognize it, it's very important for us to recognize it. Otherwise, we go along thinking it's all on us. We got to do it all by ourselves. Or maybe rope some other person in or a group in. Now, that's wonderful to be part of another group, of a group, part of a relationship. But remember, we are none of us, not them, not us, not anyone, doing it by ourselves. We are not alone. We are not alone. And as we recognize that, as we recognize that in community we thrive, we don't just get along, we don't just get by, but to thrive in a community takes commitment, doesn't it? It takes commitment. It takes courtesy. It takes communication, right? It takes concession sometimes. And it takes praise, too. It takes praising where we are in the moment. It takes praising what it is we're working with. It takes praising the people we're working with. It takes praising what it is that we are expecting to manifest through us or for us before we see it. Because we know that out of substance, out of God, all things visible and invisible come. We are not doing ourselves and our high consciousness credit to just praise what is in front of us or what we expect that we alone can bring forth from either the money we've made or the relationships we're in or the investments, whatever, it doesn't, or the education we have. To think that that's our source of good, we are actually holding up a barrier to the greater good, to think that that's our source of good alone. What we want to do is as we're going into this month of thriving together and thriving in all the places we want to thrive in, being prosperous together, being joyful together, being in community together, contributing what we feel like contributing, being part of a greater idea, helping to build something that's greater than we are, but that will bless the world as we go into that. Let us go into it with ease and allow the harmony that's within us to be the driving force, so to speak. The song within us, the melody within us, be that which moves us forward. Do you know how hard it is to be cranky when there's a good song on the radio or your MP or whatever it's called? I can't remember. Anyway, the headphones. It's really hard to be cranky when there's something you love you're listening to. So listen to that inner voice because it'll sing to you every single time you are quiet enough to listen. And it sings in harmony with life. And it brings forth this incredible peace within us that we can step forward with, regardless of what we're looking at. But it's really important that we do this together. We do this together. Together we thrive. That's just powerful, powerful. I want to tell you this little story about a group of people that were gathered at this fundraiser. Nice people, big fundraiser, beautiful food on the table. But in the setting of this elaborate dinner, they realized that the implements they were given, the fork, the spoon, the knife, were all a foot long. They were way too long, and they couldn't feed themselves gracefully. Here's all this food at this banquet table, all this beautiful food, and they're trying to look good while they're... How disappointing, right? Well, down the street, there was another fundraiser going on. Same kind of setup, beautiful, elaborate tables with beautiful food. And people who liked each other, people at both of them. But at the other banquet, they had the same utensils, right? Those foot-long spoon, fork, salad fork, knife. But the people there were feeding each other. They were feeding each other. There was joy. There was enjoyment. There was laughter. And that's what we do. That's what we do. We don't stand here and say, I'll do the best I can by myself. We come together in community, and we do this in community. We feed each other. And in doing so, in nourishing the other, we nourish ourselves. We are being nourished. We want to remember that. We want to remember that. It takes both of us. It takes all of us in a community to really bring out the greatness of that community and that group to give forth. It takes all of us. And we're encouraged to do that. I love this. We're going to do some spiffing up of our center here. Spiffing up, I call it. It looks like a major job to me if I had to do it all by myself. But praise God, I don't. Because not only do people come with great suggestions, and mind you, through the pandemic, I just have to go back to that. I'll be living with that for the rest of my life. Things just slid, you know, we just got by. We survived. We're no longer in that mode, and so therefore we don't want to survive or even think about living off of the past. So we'll take what was really good. We have this wonderful building, we have the wonderful community, and we're going to spiff up our center a bit. But here's what I love. The people who come with great ideas, and they do have great ideas, also come with, I can help. Or I know how we can get this done. You know, we come together in community, and I love that. No one's feelings are hurt because we all want the same thing. We might say, well, but I like this color, and she likes that color. And you know what I'm saying. That's where we come to a compromise. How about half the wall gray and half of it blue? Just kidding. That should have gotten a better laugh than it did. Yeah, yeah. We have the grace of God within this community. We have the power of spirit within this community. And what we do to live and thrive in this community is we use the power of prayer. And we call it the power of prayer, of affirmative prayer. Because what we need to do with affirmative prayer is get ourselves in alignment with truth. What is truth? Truth is there's only one life. The only life there is the life of God in us, through us, for us, as us. That's truth. That's truth. There's a little thing I say in the morning. I don't know where I found it, and I probably messed it up a little bit, so I won't quote. I have no quote to quote. But anyway, it's this. The gracious absolute that is within me is informing me of high truth. The gracious, or we could say the understanding, absolute, that is within me, is informing me of high truth. I say that in the morning and I say it at night because it's a greater truth than anything I could read or hear or see or make up or believe. It's a greater truth because truth, that of God, is unalterable. And if we want to live in that consciousness or bring ourselves into the consciousness where we're speaking the spirit of truth, then we have to recognize that it is there. It's absolute. It's the only thing I'm absolutely clear about. That and death, really and truly. That's the only two things. I used to say, somebody would say something to me like, do you like that? Or would you go there? Absolutely not. Absolutely. I don't say that anymore. Because it doesn't leave any room for anything else. But with God, there is nothing else. With spirit, there is nothing else. So when we go into prayer, when we do that affirmative prayer, we start with the recognition, God is. God is. And we're a part of that. So when we bring ourselves into that power, we are a part of the only power that is. We are a part of the only grace and power and love there is. Then we move into the law. And then we can command the law. And the law is within us. We aren't commanding a law out there. We're commanding the law within us, the law of mind. There's only one law, and it's all over, and it's within us. It's all over. I like to live by the law of love. But I also like the law of attraction, you know? The law of consequence. No, that's called... anyway... Only if I could direct it, I would like that law. The law of life is what we live in. And we direct it with our thoughts. With our thoughts powered by our feelings. And as they come into a recognition within us, as we recognize that's where the power is, that we really are directing our lives, whether it's going very well or very poorly or both and either or. We are directing it. We are contributing to it. We are giving it forth. It's kind of like the guy that went into the city and went to the Chamber of Commerce and said, I want to know what the city is like. The person at the desk said, well, what was the city like that you left? And he said, it was really tough to live in. It was really tough. People were unfriendly. Everybody was out after the almighty dollar. I was, that's too bad. He said, what are people like here? He said, same kind. Then another person came into the Chamber of Commerce just not shortly afterwards. And he said, I'm just new to this valley. I want to know what the people are like here. He was asked the same question. What are the people like that you left? Oh, it was hard to leave. But I have family here now, so I came here. But they were lovely. We had a great community. We had, I went to a wonderful center and, you know, just all wonderful things. And the guy at the chamber said, you're going to find the same kind of people here. You know, it's the perspective we have. It's the attitude we have. It's the beliefs we carry around. It's the same thing all the time. I always talk about our beliefs. Because they are what power us. And we love the idea that we can make a change in a moment. If Jesus could do it, we can do it. And Jesus commanded people, pick up your bed to the crippled person. I mean, that is a command, is it not? His teaching was so simple, and it was about the power within us. And his works were the demonstration of what he taught. Why would we not believe, if we believe in anything, why would we not believe that we have within us power? Because there's all kinds of evidence throughout history of people expressing their personal power in a greater way than those around them, right? It wasn't necessarily always, well, for the good, but they had the power and they knew it. Napoleon. Absolutely brilliant mind, wasn't he? Napoleon had a brilliant mind. And you know what? He won battles they said he'd never win. But ultimately, he lost his battle. And I was reading and reading in this history, and I'm like, what's going on here? And you know what it was? His focus and his strategy was to not be defeated. Now, do you see where the energy was going? There's not being defeated, and there's being successful. We have to be really clear with ourselves how much energy. Of course, not being defeated is part of being successful, but where does the majority of your energy go? Because you're powering the power of the law of mind at all times with it, for yourself, through yourself, as your experience. So the principle, the first principle of the law of mind is that there's a universal presence of intelligence. There is a universal presence of intelligence. And because there's only one, we have it within us also. And we will experience it to the degree that we acknowledge it, believe it, and put a cap on it. I say put a cap on it because we all put a cap on it. I can do this, but oh, I could never do that. I'd love to do this, but this is what I can achieve. What if we didn't put a cap on any of it? What if? What if the universe was always saying yes? You want to be wealthy? Yes. How will it feel to be wealthy in money, prosperity? Yes. How will you share it? Yes. How will you do this? The universe does not, the law of mind does not ask us how, but it always affirms what we're saying. I would love to be wealthy, but I don't know how I'm going to do that. Oh, you bet, honey. I can support that all the way around. I don't know how you're going to do it. I'd love to be wealthy, but, and, you know, we just want to take a breath. I want to take a breath. I have to tell you, I am so impressed by our music department. Because every Sunday, these people come together and bring out the most beautiful, heart-touching music. Now, if I had to determine how it was going to be done, not. If I was responsible for it, it wouldn't happen. I don't have it. I couldn't even direct the best of them and have it come out as well as it does. You see, we all have gifts. We just need to know what they are. But as I'm saying that I couldn't do it like it's being done up here, I'm not putting myself down. I'm just facing a fact. But I can really do something else. I don't know what right now, but I'll think of it. Yeah, yeah. Oh my goodness. So, life is for us today. This is what Ernest Holmes said. Life is for us today. For us today. There'll be no change for tomorrow unless we do the changing today. So let's not put it off. I saw a sign down the street in front of another church, and it says, how do you expect to get spiritually fit if you only work out on Sundays? I love that. Isn't that great? Isn't that great? And that's what Ernest Holmes is saying without as much humor. Today we are setting in motion the power of tomorrow. We really are. Today we are setting in motion the power of tomorrow. Today is God's day, and we must extract from it. We must extract from life what we want to live with. Yeah. We take that breath. We start with the idea we are a thriving community. Do you know it takes every one of us to thrive in this community? There are so many gifts that come into this church. The music, the soundboard, the cleaning, the painting, the you name it, the groundskeeping, everything. Gifts that come in here that are bought for us to use, like this podium or whatever, as well as the giving that takes place every Sunday. It isn't one thing that keeps us going. It's everything from everyone. And that's how life is. And if you're feeling a lack within, what part of your life are you not in community with? And I'm not talking about going out there. I'm talking about within here. What are you not in community with? What have you said you can't have? What have you said you're lacking in or was taken from you? What have you said you want, but you're not sure how it'll come to you? I say the power of prayer. The power of prayer. Have a definite idea of what you want. I want peace in my life. I want joy in my life. I want prosperity in money. I want prosperity in health. I want prosperity in relationships. I want success in my business. Whatever it is you want. I want to travel. But traveling, when we pray, what do you want to feel like when you travel? Go to the feeling, too. It can't just be, I'd like to go to Ireland on Tuesday the 17th. Thank you, God. And so it is. And you're laughing, and so is God. Let me tell you. God is not poor. God is not afraid. God is not limited. God is not sick. God is all there is. And we can ask for anything that our hearts desire. And we put the passion to it. And when we recognize and praise that there's a possibility, the possibility lives right here. Because as I said earlier, everything visible and invisible is already created of the one substance. As we recognize that, we draw to us. That's called the power of attraction. That's called the law of attraction. That's called the law of love. When we give our love to that which created us and out of which we experience life on the highest order that we can, doing the best we can with what we have in the time we're here, we're going to have good lives. We're going to continue to have good lives. And so it is. And so it is. Oh. Mind is the realm of cause. Mind is the realm of cause. Your mind is the realm of cause. That's what we want to recognize. And as we move into prayer, we must recognize that we are giving up fear. We must recognize that we're giving up ideas of lack. Recognize them so that you do it. That's what you're willing to do. Give up those fears. Heavenly Father, I love you. I know you're all that there is. And I know that out of you I am. And as I am, everyone else is. Heavenly Father, I'm so grateful that out of your love you created everything that is. And out of this creation, I am claiming health. I'm claiming that you are the health of life, and that health lives within my body, and that my experience is the health of God, and that anything that looks on like health, I turn my face from and claim the health of God. Not when the circumstance or condition changes, but in this moment, I claim my body experiencing the health of God. And I allow myself to be aware that in this moment I'm breathing the breath of God, and the breath of God is breathing me. The power of life is flowing through my body. And I can look to the right or look to the side of that which has pained me, or I can look to the other side, that which is true of me. And as I claim health for myself, I claim that for each one of us, that whatever the desire is upon our hearts, that we know and we accept and we believe and we have faith in thee and in the power of life, the life that we are each given, each have been given. And that in which we move and live and have our beingness in. And so for all other claims of good upon the hearts of everyone who is listening or who is here today, I claim their good for them. For there is no barrier between spirit and its creation. And so may those ties be loosened that said there was such a thing as not enough, lack, pain, anger, loss, depression that could hold us from our good permanently. Those are just experiences of life. They are not the truth. The spirit of truth is God is all there is. And we recognize that. And knowing that the intelligence of the universe flows through each one of us. Oh, I bless that. I bless that genius within each one of us that we claim and name and give thanks for and experience our good. And for the joy in this moment, for the blessings of each God person that is in this room and is listening to us, I say thank you, God. I'm so blessed. We are all so blessed. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And together we thrive. Together we thrive. We prosper. We live fully in the success of love. Thank you, God. And so it is. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
Take a moment and allow the truth of Reverend Yvonne's words that we need to embrace our good and be grateful for it. Let it settle in your hearts for a second. And now I'd like to thank those who have joined us online. We thank you for your continued support, and we hope you join us again next week. The support we give this community.